Hey guys, it's Alley Cat and the Black Cat, and today I'm doing another haul video for you guys. And it's kind of a random haul. It's not just from one place, and it was actually the last couple of days. And I've been meaning to do this video, but things have just been busy. If you haven't watched my life update video, watch that. It'll explain why I've been a little MIA for the past 2 weeks. I know. I'm so sorry. I apologize. I really do. You know, life just gets in the way sometimes. So anyway, this is my haul video, and there's lots and lots of goodies in this. And by random, when I say random, I mean random. I have books. And they're not craft books, like witchcraft books. They're just basic books, but I thought I would share with you guys because I'm a book nerd and I love reading. We've talked about this before. I've got craft haul stuff. I've got some stuff I'm going to show you that I got for my birthday. Even though my birthday was in January, I didn't get to see my best friend Amanda until a few weeks ago when we went to our Garth video, which I'm working on that video, hopefully getting that up soon. So when I saw her was the first time that I was able to get my birthday presents that she had for me. And I just adore them. I love them so much. And it shows how much she knows me. Like, she really knows me. So we'll start with those first. So these are my belated birthday presents from my best friend Amanda. I love you, Amanda. I love you, my moose. So these are some of my items. Trying to get it without the glare. She knows I love pins. I have a whole bag with nothing but these little pins that you get them at like Hot Topic and like Five Below and shit. And this one's the Hufflepuff one because that's my Hogwarts house. I'm a Hufflepuff. Hufflepuff proud! Yeah. I also got a Hogwarts one, the Hogwarts crest, and I got a collection of four, get it without the glare, and it has the, I think this is the new Rebels, or is that the Imperial? I'm not sure. I have not seen Rogue One yet. I just bought it. I didn't get a chance to see it in the theaters with my dad, and I have to be patient and wait to watch it with my dad because it's a daughter, you know, daddy thing. So, but these are the symbols. I know this is the Rebellion's symbol, and then, of course, Fight the Empire. I was going to say, I think it's the Galactic Empire symbol is this one. And then, of course, there's Princess Leia's silhouette. Princess Leia. Rest in peace, Carrie Fisher. But I have those pins, and I'm excited for those. She also got me a little Harley Quinn Pop keychain figure. I love it! I'm a big Harley Quinn fan, and I love her representation in the Suicide Squad video movie. It's freaking phenomenal. I love her. She's badass. So, she got me that, which it was on my keys, but I took it off for this video. And she also got me a bracelet that has jerk on it with a little supernatural anti-possession symbol because she and I both love Supernatural, and she was like my first and foremost friend that I knew that absolutely loved Supernatural as much as I did. And when we became like really close and best friends, we started like calling each other bitch and jerk, like Sam and Dean do in the show. So because she's a Sam girl and I'm a Dean girl, I'm the jerk and she's the bitch. So we have matching bracelets. So her says bitch. And with that note, we also do, if you watch the show, Crowley always calls them Moose and Squirrel. He calls Dean the Moose and, or Dean the Squirrel and Sam the Moose. Oh my lord. So again, she's my moose and I'm her squirrel. So I have a necklace with the pentacle and the squirrel, which I totally wore both of those to my Garth Brooks concert that we went to together, which was amazing, by the way. And I'm really hoping that I can get this video enough that you guys can see it, because YouTube hit me with a copyright claim on it. But I'm hoping I can get it so you guys can at least see how much fun and enjoyment it was and how amazing of a performer he is in concert. So, moving on. From the Garth Brooks concert, I'm going to show these because I did not show them in the Garth Brooks video. I didn't think about it. I already have seen Garth twice before this concert. So this will be my third time seeing him. And I'm just absolutely in love with him and Trisha Yearwood now. Really am. So I got a Garth t-shirt and sweatshirt at the first concert I went to of his. So this concert, I was like, what am I going to get for like souvenirs? And I didn't have anything Trisha, so I had to get Trisha. So I got her t-shirt. And it's got her signature symbol, the TY. And then the back just has her name, her signature, with Garth Brooks and world tour and how long it's been going on. I love that. It's crossed out, says Mr. Yearwood. I just now finally saw that. Oh, and it's got all of her. I didn't even see that. Shows how much I pay attention, right? The TY of her signature is made out of all of her songs, her hit songs. X's and O's, American Girl, Prize Fighter, In Another's Eyes. I love that song. Georgia Rain, another really awesome song. Wrong Side of Memphis, which that song was stuck in my head after the concert because she performed that and she doesn't normally perform that. How Do I Live, Walk Away Joe. I love Walk Away Joe. And of course, She's in Love with the Boy. So I got that t-shirt. Oh, and Jingle's up there. You can't see her because she's black, but that's right there she is. Always saying hi. Always saying hi. And then I just absolutely needed this hoodie. This is Trisha's hoodie. The inside of her hood is red. And then it's got the boxing glove on this side. And it's also got it on the back, which goes so it looks like it's dangling over her shoulders. Because her song Prize Fighter is about battling breast cancer. And I just love that. I love that she uses the boxing gloves as it. And then it's got, down here it's got her signature symbol, the TY in red. And then on this sleeve it has the Garth signature and his label and world tour underneath it. And then on this side, this is why I had to get this sweatshirt, is the Prize Fighter wrote across it. And it's so super soft. It really is. The t-shirt and the sweatshirt are. But I do have a question on this. So I'm asking all of my ladies out there, you know, gentlemen too, if you know, the black dye on this sweatshirt keeps bleeding when I wash it, and it's rubbing off. Like, it literally, I haven't noticed it right now because I haven't been playing with it too much. Like, I'm not wearing it, but I notice when I wear it and I put my hands in the pocket, or if I rub my hands against like the sleeves or something, the black dye like brushes off, like flakes off, and then it gets on my hands and like under my nails and stuff. And I was trying to figure out where this black stuff was coming from, and then I realized it was coming from this. And like after I've washed it and dried it, there's like black stuff all over the washer and dryer. I gotta clean it out. So if anybody knows any tricks to keep that from bleeding and flake the dye from flaking off, let me know in the comments down below, because I need to figure something out. I did see something with vinegar, but I'm not really sure if I should do that. I mean, it's just a cotton sweatshirt. There's nothing fancy to it, so let me know. Okay, moving on. I'm just trying to figure out where I'm going to start next. Okay, so the next place I went the last couple of days, the last week or two, was Five Below. I had to pick up a charger for my phone. I had a gift card from my birthday that I hadn't used yet. And I was like looking around and they had craft stuff. You know me and my craft stuff. They had these huge sets of five glitter glues and they had the neon, the colors. I had to get the colors right. And they also had a set of the metallic ones. So there's black, a like steel gray, a silver, a white, and a gold. And then by the glitter packs, like they had so much stuff there. I just wanted to just take my hands and go into my cart. But they also had these pack of acrylics, 12 acrylic paints. You get 6 neon and 6 metallic. So I was really liking them. And I really like these metallic ones. Like this one is really pretty. It's like a rose gold. And then like almost like a, I want to say this is like a bronzish, copperish maybe. Like I think of a really shiny, shiny penny when I see this one. So that's what I got from Five Below. Not much, but I got enough from there. And then Target, I stopped at Target with my parents the other day when we were out on our errands, and I wasn't really like getting anything, but I was just kind of browsing, and I always check out their like $1 to $5 section, and I found these really cute paper tags. They say like Hello Spring on them, and this one says Enjoy the Little Things. Which, if you guys follow me on my Instagram, and I'll leave a link below, like, you're more than welcome to follow me on Instagram. I'm doing this sticky positivity challenge, so every day I'm writing something I'm positive about on a sticky note. And that was one of the things I did on day 3, I believe, was enjoy the little things. And I just love these prints, like, they're so cute, and they're only $1. And then they had on these rub-on transfers, like, spring is in the air, peachy. I think it says Live Life Bloom that's over here, that's behind the sticker. But, I mean, these would be awesome for in my journal, my book of shadows, something. So I grabbed those. Just those little things. Not much there, but enough. And then the Dollar Tree, I stopped and got a couple of different things. I stopped in because I had to pick up some tea lights because I was low. And I don't use like a ton of tea lights, but I use a good bit. So I picked up a pack of 16 of them. And then while I was there, I was thinking of like all the craft stuff I have, like paint and all these odds and ends that I'm going to be doing. So I picked up these things because I thought these would be really great to store some bits and, you know, bits and pieces, bits and odds in it. I was looking for their, I know that they've had them, the little like organizing bins that have all the little compartments and then the doors, like the door shuts and latches. But the only one that my dollar store had, the latch was broke. So I was like, I'm not going to get this. And I couldn't find where the other ones were. And then I saw these in the sticker aisle this spring. And I'm just so loving spring, and I love spring, as you guys well know. And then I found this really awesome magnet that says "All I see is magic," and I was like, "Yes, I gotta have that." So I got that. And then I picked up some packs of sequins. These ones are pink, red, and purple. And there are 6 bags in each of these packs. And this is all like metallics. Gold, bronze, copper, brown, bronze. Yeah. And then these ones are green and blues, which I'm definitely going to use these in my upcoming mask craft that I'm going to be doing, and I'm going to be doing a video on that, so those are going to get used. I've got an idea in my head. And then just because I'm just stocking up on craft stuff and I saw that they had pink feathers. Who doesn't need pink feathers? I need pink feathers. I need everything pink. So I grabbed those. And then this was a pleasant surprise. Those of you who follow me and have seen my organizing and creating Book of Shadows video, I had commented, and if you watch my life update video, I also talk about it in there, about how I'm working on an Aphrodite bath and beauty altar in the bathroom. And I kind of already had like stuff in there and I didn't really realize that it was kind of an altar. And what better way, you know, if it's in the bathroom and it's, you know, where I put on, you know, my makeup and where I usually do my hair and things like that. You know, I'm working on my beauty on the outside and bathing myself in beauty and everything. It would be perfect place for a Aphrodite altar, right? I mean, she's the goddess of beauty and love and lust and all those things. So, and I already have like seashells in there and lighthouses and some really awesome things. I'm going to be doing a video on that too in the near future when I have it all complete. But I found this. Well, I found this one. They were a really pleasant surprise. They're little candle holders. So that one. And then the other one is slightly different. Yeah, I was going to say, I thought so. This one was silver and it's got a seahorse on it. And they had one with a sand dollar on it. And there was, I think it was a seashell, the curl like seashell ones, like the ones you think of like hermit crabs would wear or like a snail would wear, the circular ones. So I have those still. They're perfect. And then these I just picked up because I'm planning on doing my giveaway and I'm planning on sending out some love mail. And some of the things I want to add, I need like something to store them in. And organza bags from the dollar store. You ever want to find little organza bags, go to the dollar store. Even though these are in the baby shower section, like see, you can see it's baby shower. Oh, baby on it. They have them in pink. They have them in blue. They have them in green. They have them in white with pink, yellowish. They have, I think, a white with a blue. They have all different kinds. Like, these are perfect for my giveaway and for some love mail. So, I got those. Oh, and I think that was it. Nope, I lie. I lie. I also, this is also in paper. I got an idea to do another craft, which I talk about in my life update video, to do elemental jars. And so these are just little glass jars. I found them in like the candle aisle at the Dollar Tree. And I got four of them. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint on them. So if you're curious, watch the life update, because I talk about how I'm going to do it in there. And yeah, that's it for store, like the other stores. Now we're getting into the books. So while I was out with Amanda and hanging out with her for my Garth Brooks concert and everything and just spending time with her, I haven't seen her in so long. You know, life just gets in the way and you don't have time to see your friends and do things with them and schedules conflicting and everything. And she lives on the south end of my town. So it's like a good like 20 to 30 minutes to get back and forth to her house, like to get there. So a lot of the times, you know, we just don't have time to see one another. So while we were spending time with each other, I mentioned, the bad influencer that I am, that we should stop at BAM, which is Books a Million, and, you know, do a book haul trip. And if you've seen my friend Amanda's house, it's loaded with bookshelves. Think of Belle from Beauty and the Beast and that, like, library of nothing but books. That's pretty much Amanda. She's got bookshelves in every single room of her house, I think. And they're filled with books. So she really doesn't need more books. But you just can't stop when you love them and you love to read as much as we do. So I kind of influenced her to go. And I mean, you guys have seen my bookshelves. I only have two sets and they're filled. That I'm actually stacking them on the front. So I started, we went to BAM and I started in the bargain section because that's where I shop. I love my thrifts. I love my thrifty sections, my bargains, and what can I say? I'm thrifty. I like to live cheap. So I also had a gift card for BAM. So I was like, this is burning a hole in my pocket. I've had this since Christmas. I need to use it. And so I got a lot of books. So I'm thinking, yeah, I think I'm just going to start with this one for the first one. The first one I'm picking for you guys is Every Day by David Leviathan. I found the sequel to this in the bargain section and it sounded so good, the concept. I was like, this is really interesting. And then thank God for Amanda because she's like, you know, this is a sequel, right? I was like, what, really? And she's like, yeah. She's like, it says something about, you know, read this first for a story. And I was like, oh. So this is the first one and it's called Every Day. And it says, I wake up. Immediately, I have to figure out who I am. It's not just the body. Opening my eyes and discovering whether the skin on my arm is light or dark. Whether I'm a boy or girl, scarred or smooth, the body is the easiest thing to adjust to if you're used to waking up in a new one each morning. It's the life, the context of the body, that can be hard to grasp. Every day, I am someone else. I am myself. I know I am myself. But I am also someone else. It has always been like this. And it's just so interesting. You don't hear of books like that. Like basically, and as you can tell, I started reading it. I got my little bookmark that Amanda made for me. I have a couple of them. She does cross-stitch bookmarks. This is my supernatural one with all the characters. And this is Jerk and the Chevy Impala, Dean, Sam, Cass, Crowley, Charlie, Bobby. She does several of them. I have a Doctor Who. I have a Star Wars. She's working on Harry Potter one for me. And she sells them too. So I will leave a link to her Facebook page, Amanda's Geeky Stitchery, down below if you're interested. So I started reading this and it's really interesting. It's basically about, like I said, about this boy named A who just keeps waking up in a different body every day. And he has to struggle to figure out who he is each time. And when he woke up, trying to find, where is it? Aha! When he wakes up in the body in the first one, he meets a girl named Rhiannon. The sequel, this is the one I found in the bargain section. This one was with $5.97. So this one was the only one I paid full price for, and this was $9.99. So still not bad, but this was $5.97, and this one says, every day is the same for Rhiannon. She has accepted her life, convinced herself that she deserves her distant, temperamental boyfriend, Justin, even established guidelines by which to live. Don't be too needy. Avoid upsetting him. Never get your hopes up. Until the morning everything changes, Justin seems to see her, to want to be with her for the first time, and they share a perfect day. A perfect day Justin doesn't remember the next morning. Confused, depressed, and desperate for another day as great as that one, Rhiannon starts questioning everything. Then one day, a stranger tells her that the Justin she spent that day with, the one who made her feel like a real person, wasn't Justin at all. So what? So this is Rhiannon's story. And it says about, in every day, you hear the story of A. Rhiannon's side of the story as she seeks to discover the truth about love and how it can change you in another day. So this is basically her waking up in hers. In her different day. So these are Every Day and Another Day by David Leviathan. The next book I picked was Famous in Love by Rebecca Searle. I think I'm saying that right. This is going to be a freeform original series, and I've been seeing the previews for it, and it sounds amazing, and it sounds like my type of shizzle, so I grabbed it. And it's about this girl, Paige Townsend, and she's an actress, and she gets starred in a big blockbuster movie about a book series, and her life changes overnight. And with, you know, before you know it, she's on the film set and she's spending time with her co-star, Rainer Devon, one of people's sexiest men alive. And then troubled star Jordan Wilder lands the role of the other point in the love triangle in this series. And her life starts to resemble her character's. And I just love that. I love triangles. Like, I love reading books and watching series on it because it always leaves you hanging. You just, like, want them to hook up with one or the other. So I picked up that one. And then I picked up... I was really excited to see both the first and the second. The first and the sequel of these in the bargain section. And this is Until Friday Nights by Abby Glines. And this was $3.97. I have been seeing this on the booktubers that I watch. They've been talking about this and they say it's really, really good. So I had to pick that up. And it says, to everyone who knows him, Wes Ashby has always been that guy. You know that guy. We've all known that guy in high school, right? The one that every guy wants to be and every girl wants to date him and loves him. That's pretty much what Wes Ashby is like. And he's the big man on campus. But he's grief-stricken on the inside because he's watched his father slowly die of cancer. And he hasn't been able to tell anybody. And then 2 years before this, Maggie Carlton witnessed her father murder her mother. And afterwards, she told the police what happened and then never spoke again. So she's, like, pretty much mute. Like, she doesn't talk to anybody. And after moving to Lawton, Alabama, which is where this happens, at Lawton High, to live with her uncle, and she meets Wes, and they talk after a post-game party, and he basically tells her everything that he can't tell anyone else. And what he expects is a flood of emotions, relief, but he didn't expect was for Maggie to reply, because she's mute. For her to reveal a pain even deeper than his own. For them to form a connection so strong that he couldn't ever let her go. Oh, I love romance. I'm a hopeful romantic. So I love books like this. So then, of course, I had to get the sequel or companion novel. I'm not really sure this has to do with this. The same exact main characters or like secondary characters, but this is Under the Lights, and it basically says the party continues. And this, I don't think it is. I think this is about two different characters, Willa and Gunner. Yeah. And another character, Brady. But I love Abby Glines books, so I know I'm going to love these. So I picked these up. And this one is because it's a hardback, was $5.97. And then the next book I got was Vitro by Jessica. I'm sorry if I butcher names. It's really hard sometimes. Look at that. Is it Corey? I'm saying Corey. Jessica Corey. This is one of those where I was like, ooh, this is a new concept. I like this. This is basically about an island called Skin Island where the laws of creation can be broken. It's a remote island in the Pacific. Scientists have privately funded this island and made this mysterious corporation its, like, headquarters there called Corpus. And they have taken test tube embryos and given them life. These beings, the Vitros, have knowledge and abilities most humans can only dream of. But they have one enormous flaw. And then it says about 17-year-old Sophie Crew wants to get on this island, so she enlists the help of a young charter pilot, Jim, and she arrives and discovers, and she's going there to find her mother that left her when she was very young. And she discovers a terrifying secret, that she has a Vitro twin named Lux, who is the culmination of Corpus's dangerous research. And now Sophie's torn between reuniting with her mom and connecting with her genetically enhanced twin that she never knew existed. And basically, it's you're trying to find out what happens when science stretches too far beyond its reach. And I love when people make you really I love when books make you question things or think about things. And it says about that this novel explores the question, when does science cross the line? And I think with the way technology is getting and how we've become so enhanced with things, like, you start to wonder, like, when does it start to cross the line? So definitely sounds like a good book. That one was, if I didn't already say it, was $3.97. The next book is How to Love Another Name, Katie Katungo. That's what I'm going with. Katie Katungo. And this one was $5.97. And it's about a girl named Rena who has loved Sawyer all her life, but he's never seemed to notice her. Story of my life. Have had a lot of unrequited love in my life, a lot. But one day, apparently, Sawyer notices Rena and starts to talk to her, and they fall in love, and then he just disappears from their Florida town without a word, leaving her devastated and pregnant. And then 3 years pass, and there's a new love in her life, her daughter, Hannah. And she's gotten used to life without Sawyer. And just as swiftly and suddenly as he disappeared, he reappears. And she doesn't want anything to do with him, but she's letting him get close to their daughter, Hannah. And after everything that's happened, can Rena really let herself love Sawyer LaGrange again? And this is basically a story of one couple falling in love twice. Again, I'm a hopeful romantic. I love love stories. So I felt compelled to get it. Do you ever have those feelings when you just like pick something up and before you even really read what it's about or really like do more in, you know, research or information on whatever this object is, that you found that your instincts were, my intuition is normally always on point. With books, I literally just stand there and scour the shelves and wait till a title or something like calls to me and beckons my attention. And then that's when I'm like, okay, I'm going to pick you up. And normally, like within a moment of me picking up and holding the book in my hand, I'm like, if I know it right then and there, sometimes I don't even read it. I'll be like, yep, I know. And then when I read it later, I'm like, ha, yeah, I was right. So the next one I got was Cinder by Marissa Meyer. Maybe it's Mayer. Again, I'm sorry if I butcher the names. But this is the start of the Lunar Chronicles. And I have heard so many good things, again, about this series. And I love sci-fi and fantasy. And I love fairy tales. And I love fairy tale retellings. And that's what the Lunar Chronicles is. Because this is obviously a retelling of Cinderella. And Cinderella is one of my absolute favorite fairy tales. That and Snow White. So this one is like in the future. And it's about humans and androids in New Beijing. But a deadly plague ravages the population. And no one knows that Earth's fate hinges on one girl, 16-year-old Cinder. She's a gifted mechanic and a cyborg. And she's a second-class city citizen with a mysterious past and is rivaled by her stepmother. And when her life becomes intertwined with Prince Kai, she suddenly finds herself at the center of an intergalactic struggle. Intergalactic, planetary, intergalactic. And a forbidden attraction. Ooh. Caught between duty and freedom, loyalty and betrayal, she must uncover secrets about her past in order to protect her world's future. Because there is something unusual about Cinder, something that others would kill for. Ooh. Now, there's a couple other ones. She also has Scarlet, Crest, and the Fairest. Fairest is about Snow White, I know. Scarlet's about Red Riding Hood. And Crest is about Rapunzel. And she just came out with Heartless, which I think is Alice in Wonderland. The Queen of Hearts. I might be wrong, but I think that's what that's about. I'm pretty certain. Don't quote me on that. Okay. And Cinder was $5.97. And then this book, Ice Kissed, is the second in a series of the Kanan Chronicles about the world of Trell. T-R-Y-L-L-E. I think it's Trell. That's how I say it. And this is by Amanda Hawking. I have the first one, Frostfire. I bought that on the bargain section once on one of my last trips. So I picked this one up because I know when I read the first one, like the first synopsis, I haven't gotten around to reading Frostfire yet. But I know when I read it, I was like, oh, this is really interesting. I want to get the second one when it comes out. And the third one, The Crystal Kingdom, is soon coming out. So, or if I'm not mistaken, it might have just been released. I'm not sure. But this was $3.97. And basically, it's kind of hard for me to give you the synopsis on this because this is a sequel. But it's about this girl named Bryn Avon, and she lives in this kingdom of a realm. And I remember that there's like something special about them. Like there's certain people, like tribes, I guess, so to speak, of them that like have higher power. Again, I'm really sorry. I should have pulled Frostfire to give an explanation of like what the series is about. But this is the sequel to that one. The next book I got, I should do, was another part of a series. The bargain price section, Min and I had a discussion about this, is usually always series of books. So it's really helpful to have her along sometimes because she scours those shelves a lot. And so she already knows what's a sequel and what's the first. Because they like to do that. You know, they'll put the sequels to the books in the bargain section. So you're like, oh, this sounds really good. And you can get it for a bargain. But in order to start the series, you have to buy the first one at full price, retail price. And sometimes it can get pretty pricey. And even though, like, I am all for, you know, I love reading and I love, you know, giving credit to authors and stuff like that, it's very rare that I will pay full retail price for a book. And that's only because I read a lot. I mean, you guys have seen my bookshelves. You should only see how much books I have on my Kindle. I read a lot, a lot, a lot. My dad always called me a bookworm. I always have my nose in a book. He said, if you can't find Angie, go look. She's probably in a corner with her nose in a book somewhere. Because that's me. I carry books with me everywhere I go. So it was helpful for me to have her there because I'd be like, oh, this looks good. She's like, sequel. Like, so this time she already knows everything there because they only change it out every so often. But this one was the first one in a series. And this is Rebel Belle by Rachel Hawkins. Yeah. And this, again, is another one of those books that I know is a bestseller. And the booktubers were talking about it. And I was like, oh, this sounds really, really good. but it's about Harper Price. She's a Southern belle, and she's ready for her homecoming, Tiara. But after a strange run-in at the dance, she finds out she has incredible abilities. How about that? Incredible abilities. What would I do if I found out I had incredible abilities? I'd be excited, but maybe scared too. And it says that her destiny takes a turn for the seriously weird. She becomes a paladin, one of the ancient line of guardians with agility, super strength, and lethal fighting instincts. Yeah. So see, it's kind of like magical in a way. Like, I love that. I love a lot of paranormal sci-fi fantasy books. We've talked about this. But she finds out that her life is just going to get more and more crazy. She finds out that she's charged to protect David Stark, the school reporter, who is the subject of mysterious prophecy and possibly Harper's least favorite person. And it gets even more complicated when she starts falling for him and discovers that David's fate could very well be to destroy Earth. And then, of course, there's the sequel, which I have right here, Miss Mayhem. And the first one is 397. Miss Mayhem was 397 as well. Now, that's a hardback, though. So those are the awesome ones when you find those. So I think, yeah, that's all the books I got. I know. You're like, that's all? That was a lot. You should see when we go on our book bonanza days. I might do a video when that comes up. It's usually in June. It's held at our one local skating rink, and they basically fill it up with tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of books. And it's just all over the place, all different genres. And they sell them for a dollar a hardback, 50 cents for a paperback. And it goes the whole weekend. But on Sundays, you can get a yard of books stacked like this. So measure out a yard of books stacked like this. So 3 feet of books for a dollar. That's right. $1. A yard of books for $1. And you can find some really good ones in there. So I'm excited to be going again this year, and I'll probably do a video for that. So that was all of my haul video. I know I said it was random and sporadic and kind of all over the place, but hope you enjoyed. As always, love ya. Blessed be. Have a good night.